अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? वी हैव स्टार्टेड चैप्टर नंबर 4, मैग्नेट्स एंड इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट्स। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज अ थ्योरी फॉर मैग्नेटिज्म। एक्सपेरिमेंट्स शोज द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द मैग्नेट्स एंड मैग्नेटिक मटेरियल्स, बट दे डू नॉट एक्सप्लेन व्हाट इज हैपनिंग। अ थ्योरी इज नीडेड टू एक्सप्लेन द इफेक्ट्स ऑफ मैग्नेटिज्म एंड टू हेल्प अस टू यूज इट। नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सपोर्टिंग द थ्योरी। A magnetized steel rod has a north pole at one end and a south pole at the other end. If this steel rod is broken down into smaller pieces, each piece has its own pole. You can see that this magnetized steel rod is broken down into smaller pieces. It is broken down into three smaller pieces, and each piece has its own north pole and south pole. North pole and south pole, and in this way, same way, north pole and south pole. It means breaking the magnetized steel rod into smaller pieces, and smaller pieces produce smaller and smaller complete magnets. Magnetic material like iron and steel is thought to contain tiny molecular magnets. Inside a material like iron, the molecular magnets can line up in groups called domains. In this diagram, we can see this is the piece of iron, unmagnetized iron rod, and in this unmagnetized iron rod, the domain is randomly arranged, and these domains are sensitive to magnetic field. As soon as we will put a magnet close to the piece of iron, its domain will start to line up in an orderly way. You can see that this domain has started to line up in an orderly way, and due to which this iron piece of iron is converted into magnet. It has become magnetized. Next topic is using the theory. But in order to magnetize a piece of iron, we stroke it repeatedly with a magnet. In this diagram, we can see that it is unmagnetized iron rod, and the domain is not lined up in this unmagnetized iron rod. And when we stroke it with a permanent magnet, the north pole of a magnet attracts the south pole of the molecular magnet as it moves across the iron, and as a result of which, this unmagnetized iron rod will convert into a permanent magnet. This permanent magnet can be demagnetized by heating it up and then quickly cooling it in the hot water. In this diagram, we can see that this is the magnetized iron rod in which the domain is lined up, and it has its north pole and south pole. The energy from the heating causes the molecules to move faster, as a result of which the domains become unaligned. And then it will be, we have put it into the cold water, due to which this iron magnetized iron rod become unmagnetized. Another method by which we can demagnetize a permanent magnet is hitting a magnet with hammer or simply dropping it onto the hot floor. Students, next we have to do test yourself. Question number 1, part A. What happens if a magnet is broken into two pieces? The answer is, if a magnet is broken into two pieces, each piece will have its own north and south pole. Question number 1, part B. Why is it impossible to get north or south poles on their own? The answer is, north and south pole of a magnet is not a physical quantity. It is predefined sense of direction. Question number two. Explain why heating destroys the magnetism in a permanent magnet. The answer is, energy from the heating causes a molecule to move faster and its domain become unaligned. Our next topic is magnetic induction. When a piece of iron or steel is placed near to a magnet, the magnetic domain lines up and it becomes magnetized. This is called induced magnetism. But in this diagram, we can see that this is a piece of iron, and when it is brought near to a magnet, permanent magnet, its domain line up and it become magnetized. And this process is known as induced magnetism. The induced pole closest to the magnetic north pole is a south pole. And this is why magnet attracts iron and steel. The same case is with steel. When a steel rod is brought near a permanent magnet, its domain also line up and it become a magnet. And this process is known as induced magnetism. However, when the iron is pulled away from the magnet, it loses its magnetism because it is a temporary magnet. But when a steel is moved away from a magnet, it does not magnetized. Demagnetized, and it become a permanent magnet. Our next topic is hard and soft magnetic material. Iron is a soft magnetic material because it is easy to magnetize, but it loses its magnetism easily. It is mostly used in a places where temporary magnet is needed, or where the direction of the magnetism has to be changed quickly. Steel is a hard magnetic material because it is difficult to magnetize as compared to iron, but it does not lose its magnetism easily. Steel makes a good permanent magnet. Next topic is making a permanent magnet. A permanent magnet can be made by stoking a piece of steel or iron with a permanent magnet. However, a better way of making a permanent magnet is to put a steel rod inside a coil of wire. And when electric current flows through the coil of wire, the strong magnetic poles are induced in the steel. Next, we have to do test yourself. Question number 1, what is induced magnetism? The answer is, when a piece of iron or steel is placed near a magnet, the magnetic domain line up and it become magnetized. This is called induced magnetism. That is from this line up to this line. Question number 2, explain the difference between a temporary magnet and a permanent magnet. A temporary magnet loses its induced magnetism when it is pulled away from a magnet. A permanent magnet does not lose its magnetism even when it is pulled away from a magnet. Question number 3, explain the difference between a soft and a hard magnetic material. A soft magnetic material is easy to magnetize, but it loses its magnetism easily, for example iron. A hard magnetic material is difficult to magnetize, but it does not lose its magnetism easily, for example steel. Thank you.